Hey guys, it's Kyle. It's been a while since I made a video, so I'm making one now. Been kind of MIA lately. We bought a house, and we sold a house. And the house that I'm in right now is just utterly destroyed. We moved in, and the first thing we decided to do is we're gonna, you know, replace some carpeting. So we did what everybody does, and we did it ourselves. So we flipped out on the tile. And because it's a two-story house and we don't want to move furniture a bunch, we ripped out all the tile and everything is still in the garage. So everything's still in the garage. And I got these awesome lights off Amazon. These things, they're like LED lights that you can link together. And they light up the garage like it's nothing. I mean, the little light that comes with the garage doesn't hold a candle to them. I'll post the link below for what I did with them. But so this is all of our stuff in the garage because we're putting down wood floors and we didn't want to end up moving a bunch of stuff around, you know, moving everything into the house and then to put the wood floors in, having to move all kinds of furniture around. We did that at the old house. And it was an event to get that project even finished. I mean, it went literal years. We'd finish the wood, I'd finish the floors, couldn't finish quarter round, couldn't finish a bunch of stuff because we just, you know, didn't feel like moving furniture out of the way and things like that. So I'm gonna do a quick walkthrough of our house. I'm gonna give you guys an idea of my next project once I finish the floors. A media center, a media cabinet that I have in mind. I'm not 100% sure on what it's going to look like on the end, but I have an idea of what I want. So we're going to go take a little walk through the house, and I'll probably end up doing a tour. My little nest thermostat there. So walking through the house, getting into the living room. So this was all carpet. Look, this is all carpet, and we have ripped up all the carpet to put down wood. So the wood came in today. It's actually at the shop right now, and I need to go pick it up, but it's been raining like crazy here in Jacksonville, so I didn't want to pick it up while it's raining. But what I am going to do, what I will show you guys, so I'm going to do what some people tell you not to do. What some people tell you not to do. And I'm actually gonna put my TV above the fireplace. Now, why am I gonna do that? Well, for starters, it is a fake fireplace. It's gas, whatever. We're never gonna use it. We live in Florida. It doesn't ever really get hot enough to use it. I'm gonna put the TV up here, and I can see that somebody, you know, they'd mounted it here before because there's mount holes, and you got this little electrical outlet that goes down here, you know, over here. But my plan, hopefully, will be to, camera's going crazy, put a cabinet in right here. I'm actually gonna cut open the drywall, come down, and build the cabinet into the side of the fireplace here. So above the actual fireplace. Because we're going to be removing it anyway. We're going to be taking out, putting like an electrical one in that you can actually turn on, but you don't need heat from. It's just for appearances. So that's kind of what I'm doing. So like I said, what I'm going to do is we're going to come in here, and I've already kind of made a line. We're going to cut this out because this is all hollow. And that's kind of my issue with this, really, is that somebody has built this huge fireplace in this living room, and I can't even get far enough back from it. That, I mean, it's made to be the focal point of the living room, right? Like that's how huge it is. I'm like 20 feet back. The living room is like 20 by 20, and the fireplace is huge. So the TV is gonna go there, and I got a mount that I just ordered. I'll post the link. The mount actually will go up on top. The TV will go up, but you can actually pull the TV down. So it'll be at a good suitable viewing height because you don't really want to look up to view TVs. Looking down is okay, but looking up, you can strain your eyes, strain your neck. So we're going to put the TV up here, but it's going to pull down when we want to watch it. And then we can put it up in a way when we don't need it, but also away from the kids when they play, because we have four-year-olds. So they run around and they like to break things. So we're going to do that. I'm going to run the cables into the wall, and I bought an IR repeater. I will post the link to that too. And then we're going to come and cut a cabinet out here. And I think what I'm going to be doing is putting a piece of tempered glass, like a tempered glass, maybe a smoky tempered glass door on it right here. So you can't really see what's in there, but you know, I don't want to do what the previous owners did, which is they had something like this sitting down here, and your cable box, DVD player, and TV box, whatever, all located on there. So that's why I've kind of been MIA from the YouTube world, and YouTube is just making it harder and harder to make money from them anyway. So I'm gonna go put this video together. And I also got this little Elgato thing. That was pretty neat. So hopefully I'll be able to make some more videos. Let me show you guys that real quick. Streamlabs, yes. Anyway, I had to go to the Elgato website to download the software for it. But you can program different things on there, like a camera or open broadcast or a different screen. You can reboot your computer. It's just a neat little macro tool. Obviously, I need a light in here too, because the people who built this house, before we got it, there's no light. This way. There's no light in my office. So I definitely need to get a light in there. So I have a buddy who's an electrician. He's going to come out and do that. Weird things. We found out with this house that the builder for the master bedroom ran two AC ducts, but they never put one through the actual ceiling. So it's been blowing cold air into the attic for about 10 years. The house was built back in like 2004 or 2008. 2008, it's 10 years old. So my buddy who's a AC guy just came out and cut the hole for me, and then he's coming back tomorrow to put the little louvers on it. But it's just weird stuff that, you know, you thought somebody would have figured out by, you know, 10 years from by now, and the house has had like two or three owners. So anyway, I'm gonna get to editing this video. I'm gonna use my my Stream Deck right here to start things and edit and do that kind of stuff. And, you know, hopefully it'll make it easier for me to edit videos, because stuff takes really, really long to edit videos now. And if you've ever done it, I don't know. But so that's my new project. So the floors, and I'll try to get some video of that. And then the media center. I'm more excited about that because I do tech, right? So I like technology over anything else. But we had to get the tile up, and it was amazing. It came up in like 2 hours with minimal breakage. So, and then somebody came and took it all away. Some lady wanted it, so we let her come, and she took all our tile away. Yeah, so that's what's going on. That's why I've been away, trying to come back, trying to make some more videos. Let me know what you're interested in. You know, obviously I prefer tech videos, but you know, I mean, who knows what we can do. I'm trying to launch a company, do an IT business and stuff like that, so that I can stop working for Cubicle City. And you know, maybe YouTube's the way to do it, maybe not, I don't know. Maybe doing a smart home thing, not really sure yet. So that's that for now, and I will check you guys later.